Hi guys, welcome back to Speakin' Easy. This week, we're going to talk about the four types of English sentences. Now, you've already used all four types of English sentences, so don't worry about that. But we're going to give you the definition of what they are, and we're going to give you some examples. So, let's get into it.
Number one, a declarative sentence or a statement. Declarative sentences make a statement. They tell us something. They give us information, and they normally end with a full stop or a period. The usual order in words for a declarative sentence is the subject plus verb. Declarative sentences can be positive or negative. For example, I like coffee, or I don't like coffee. Number two, interrogative sentences or questions. Interrogative sentences ask a question. They ask us something. They want information. And they always end with a question mark. The usual word order for the interrogative sentence is a WH or auxiliary plus subject plus verb. Interrogative sentences can also be positive or negative, such as, do you like football? Or, don't you like football? Number three, an imperative sentence or command. Imperative sentences give a command. They tell us to do something, and they end with either a full stop or period or exclamation mark. The usual order for an imperative sentence is base verb something something something. Note that there is usually no subject, because the subject is understood or implied. It is you. Imperative sentences can also be positive or negative. For example, hey, stop doing that. Or, don't stop doing that. Number four, the exclamative sentence or exclamation. Exclamative sentences express strong emotions or surprise. An exclamation. And they always end with the exclamation point. The usual word order for an exclamative sentence is what plus an adjective or plus a noun plus a subject plus verb. Look at these examples. What a liar he is. What an exciting movie that was.
Thanks for listening, guys. We'll catch you again in the next video. But if you have any questions before then, drop us a comment in the section below. You can ask us some questions or even give us some suggestions on what you'd like to hear. Catch you in the next video.